In this video, I'll show you how to replace the TT-AK24R shell, as well as a solution to an unexpected problem. First step, you want to unplug the power from the unit. Then take a carpet knife and carefully cut around the foil seal at the edge of the padded gasket. Cut 360 degrees around. You then want to use that box cutter or screwdriver to scrape away the foil gasket that covers the screws that are holding the unit in place in the duct. These screws, in my case, had a head that enabled me to use a socket to take them off. It was a lot easier than using the screwdriver. Once that the screws are removed, you then take a putty knife, and between the duct and the gasket, you start working away slowly and carefully to unadhere the duct and the gasket from the unit. You then want to scrape off the excess gasket from the unit using more of a chisel type device that has a sharper edge, because that gasket is very sticky and it takes some work to scrape it off. Once you scrape that off, you'll uncover four screws that hold the head of the unit in. Cat's always looking to help out, see what's going on. So once you get that off nice and clean, you want to unscrew the screws that hold in the head of the unit. Once you get those screws out, you carefully open the unit from the cylinder, the head from the cylinder. And you want to be careful here because the plug is contained in that head that plugs into the cell itself that's in the cylinder. Just showing you the screw size here. So you carefully pull that apart, pull the socket off the end of the cell. And then to remove the cell from the cylinder, you remove the three outer screws on the triangular plate. And remove the cell. Now in my case, when I tried to replace the cell, that triangular plate, the holes did not match up. Those screw holes at the ends of the triangle did not match up with the holes in the plate of the unit. No matter what I did and how I measured, they were off by about a 16th of an inch. You can even see here that the center hole that holds that the cell prong comes out of is larger on the right side than on the left, which the left is the original. So what I had to do was I had to unscrew this little mounting plate from the cell on the new unit and take the plate from the old unit and mount the cell onto that and screw it back in. Then you want to punch out the holes on the new gasket and you peel off the backing and place it over the cylinder, leaving the backing on the side that's going to adhere to the duct. You then take off the backing that's going to go on into the duct. And you replace the unit, pressing the unit into the duct so it sticks. Then replace the four screws. You get the new foil ring. Take the backing off the foil ring. That's going to cover the gasket. Place that on the duct, you plug the power back in, and hopefully you see that green light showing that it's working. Good luck.